Nick von Schirnding from Ortac Resources joins me now on Skype. Nick, good morning. Nice to speak to you.
Good morning, Andrew.
News this morning, Nick, that you're taking full control here of Casa. Run us through the thinking behind this decision, Nick.
Well, Casa is an asset that we've held a 20% equity stake in, a convertible loan in, and it's a very exciting gold prospect in the DRC in South Kivu. It has a resource currently of 1.5 million ounces. We announced very exciting drill results last week, which indicate that we're actually looking at something much bigger, in excess of 2 million ounces. So what we've announced this morning is a binding agreement to acquire just under 34% of Casa. Together, we will with that, we will also convert the convertible loan note, which those two will push us then to a 70% ownership position in Casa, and we'll be making an offer on the same terms at 55 cents to the balance of the minorities. So we will hopefully own this asset outright. It marks a major step forward in our strategy to focus on our African assets and really get our hands around an asset that's producing results, which it is.
An exciting asset, as you say. Are there any concerns, though, about operating in the Congo? I mean, especially in the East?
Well, there are, of course, always concerns wherever one operates, and the DRC does have its challenges, but no, we haven't had any major challenges to date. We've got a first-rate team on the ground there with the first-rate country manager, and we have a lot of support from the local and national government as well.
So plenty of developments, and as you were saying, they're just building on that, really marks a ramp-up in activity for Ortac Resources.
It does. So I was brought on earlier in the year really to shake things up at Ortac. The company, I think, was perceived to have lost its way a bit on its strategy. It had legacy assets in Slovakia and a minority interest in a bunch of African assets. And really, we needed to make a number of moves, first of which was to remove all the old board members and to start off with a clean slate, which we've done a few weeks ago. And then really to focus on executing our strategy. We've raised $2.2 million a week ago. And then to develop our core assets, you know, which are mainly in Africa, particularly Casa. So the results we announced last week for Casa were very exciting. I mean, we got intersects there, 25 meters in excess of 8 grams a ton, and of that, 5 meters just under 23 grams a ton. So these are really interesting results, and could be a major potential gold operation for us going forward.
Interesting results, as you say. So what are some of the next steps here for the project? What are you planning?
Well, we're continuing our drill program. So we've drilled about 2,000 out of the 5,000 meters. We've got two holes, 114 and 115, currently being processed, and we'll report back on that over the next 2 weeks or so. And then we're still drilling another two holes, 116 and 117. So we will continuously update the market as and when we get those results, and hopefully, you know, there will be encouraging results as we've seen to date.
At a much earlier stage, though, you've also got an interesting asset in Zambia. Nick, tell me a bit more about this.
Yes, so Zambia is it's much less advanced than what we have at in the DRC. So they have two licenses. One is a small mining license, an oxide resource of 16 million tons, just under 1% copper. And then they've got a much bigger, a larger license of 1,000 square meters in the Domes region. That is an interesting asset. It's obviously copper and cobalt, and you know, as you know, there's a strong tailwind behind those two commodities, and we would obviously like to increase our equity position, which is just under 20% currently. So we are in discussions with the management there, but we'll, you know, first things first, we need to bed down the Casa acquisition, but then Zamsort obviously is very interesting for us going forward. So it's another opportunity for us to drive value. And then, of course, we do have legacy assets, as I say, excuse me, in Slovakia, where I'm currently. We're trying to, again, sort out a position that's been quite difficult with NGOs and licensing issues and the use of cyanide. But it is a potentially valuable asset, and we want to look at ways to drive value there. And all of this really is part of a major restructuring of Ortac, and we'll also be renaming the company in due course.
Oh, when do you reckon we might hear a bit more on that, Nick?
Well, look, we first have to find a name, but we'll do all that work, and I'm hopeful within the next few months.
Oh, very exciting, Nick. So I'll leave the final word to you then. Focusing on driving value, acquiring the news today of the acquisition of Casa. So an exciting time here for Ortac Resources and its shareholders, by the sounds of things.
It is indeed. We've got a new board. We've got a new strategy. We've cashed up. We've got just in excess of $2.2 million. And in a very, very exciting phase in developing the Casa Gold project.
That's brilliant, Nick. Nice to speak to you. Thanks very much.
Thanks very much, Andrew.